Hello friends, I am Amog M, working as assistant professor in English in GFTCW Chikpalapur. Today I would be dealing with session number 36. The topic of the session is Novella and it comes under 4th MBA General English. So let us look at the topic of Novella from now onwards. Now first let us look at the definition and origin of novella. In literature, a novella is a type of prose fiction which is shorter than full-length novels and longer than short stories. It originates from an Italian word novella, which means new. It is a well-structured yet short narrative, often satiric or realistic in tone. It usually focuses on one incident or issue with one or two main characteristics and takes place at a single location. The novella usually contains 10,000 words to 40,000 words. So in all these things we have seen in this first slide here. Let us try to go in detail with each of the points here. In the first point, we could find out some three very important points. That is, novella is a prose fiction. It is a type of a prose fiction. Hence, novella comes under the category of prose fiction. Then we also come to know that it is shorter than novel. It is shorter than normal novels or full-length novels, whereas it is longer than short stories. So what we can say is it is an intermediary between novel and a short story. It is neither a novel, neither a normal novel, or neither a normal novel nor a short story. It is a combination of both. That is, it is shorter than novel, but at the same time it is longer than the short story. And the word novella, it originates from Italian language. The meaning of novella in Italian language is new. The novella form was originated in the 14th, 15th century. So in that period, it was a new form. So they wanted to give a name symbolizing something new. So the word novella came into existence. Then, novella is a well-structured narrative. There's some proper structure about it. It has a proper beginning. It has a proper middle. Then it has a proper ending. So the structure of the novella is very well organized. Then the novella is satiric in nature. So satire is one of the key characters of novella. Most of the novels are satires, and other than that, some of the novellas are realistic also. So novellas either deal with reality, the real issues, or they would make fun of the current situation in a dignified way, that is through satires. Then novella usually focuses on only single incident or a event or a issue, and there would be only one or two main characters. There would not be number of main characters. If you see a novel, there would be number of main characters. Some 5 to 8 main characters can be found in a novel, but whereas only one or two main characters can be found in novella. The novella usually contains 10,000 words to 40,000 words. So here we can come to know the word count of novella. As I said earlier, novella is shorter than novel, whereas it is longer than short story. So the word count is word count reflects that the word count of novella is 10,000 words to 40,000 words. The fifth author introduced the novella to England with Canterbury Tales. Geoffrey Chaucer is considered as the father of English literature. The Canterbury Tales is one of the greatest works of English literature. So he brought in the formula of novella, the formula of novella with his greatest work. Then Shakespeare and other playwrights carry forward the form of novella with them in the Elizabethan period also. These playwrights, that is Shakespeare and other playwrights, took the dramatic plots from Italian novellas and modified them according to their needs, and thus they made use of the dramatic plots in the Shakespeare and other dramatists thus became famous. The realistic content and form of these tales influenced the development of the English novel in the 18th century, the short story in the 19th century. So, novella had a huge part in the emergence of English novel in the 18th century. The formal English novel came into existence only in the 18th century. Till then, no proper novels were written. So in the 18th century only one could see the emergence of novels, proper novels in English literature. And novellas have a huge role to play in it. Actually, the English writers, the English early English novelists were inspired by these novellas, and with the help of these novellas, they came up with novel, the form of novel. Then, in the 19th century, the short story, English short story, emerged. In that also, the novella played a huge role. So, novella had a huge role to play in the emergence of short story in the 19th century. So, one could say that 18th century in English literature is dominated by novel, and at the same time, short story dominated the 19th century English literature. And in both the things, novella has huge part to play. So the early novelists and the early short story writers should thank novella creators for the emergence of novels and short stories. Now we will come to know about the differences between novella and novel. There are very important differences between novella and novel. They are page length. The most important differences are page length, number of words, theme and structure. Page length, as I said in the earlier slide, the page length of novella is much less than the normal novels. Number of pages would be more in novels compared to novellas. Number of words. A novella usually contains 10,000 words to 40,000 words, whereas novels contain lakhs of words. So there is obviously that difference is there. Then theme. There's a big difference between the theme of novella and novel. Novel deals with a grand theme, but on the other hand, novella deals with a very simple and limited theme structure. There is a difference between difference of structure in novella and novel also. Then we can also see some other differences. In novella, we can see a single central conflict, whereas in novel, we can see multiple central conflicts. A number of central conflicts can be seen in novels, whereas novella deals with a single central conflict. And fast pacing. Novellas are usually fast paced. The story moves on a fast pace. The narrative moves on a fast pace. While in novel, the narrative moves on a slow pace. So that's a big difference between novella and novel. Then there's a difference of unity of time and place. Novella deals with event happened in a single day and a single location. The novella takes place with a reference of single place, whereas novel deals with not just single event of single day, but much more than that. It deals with event that happened years back, and the unity of place is also not followed in novel, as the narrative of novel takes place in multiple places. So these are the important differences between novella and novel. Now we will come to know some of the famous novellas. There are few novellas written by some famous authors, and now we will come to know each of them. The Stranger, the Stranger, a novella written by Albert Camus. Breakfast Tiffany's, written by Truman Capote. Heart of Darkness, written by Joseph Conrad. A Christmas Carol, written by Charles Dickens. Charles Dickens is considered as one of the greatest novelists of English literature. The Old Man and the Sea, Ernest Hemingway. It is also a novella. Then The Metamorphosis, Franz Kafka. Franz Kafka is one of the greatest writers of English literature. I Am Legend by Richard Matheson is also a novella. Billy Budd, Herman Melville Day, is also a novella. And the most important work, Animal Farm. This is very, very famous novel, but it can be also considered as novella by George Orwell. Now we have come to the last part of the video, that is revision. In literature, a novella is a type of prose fiction which is shorter than full-length novels and longer than short stories. It means novella originates from an Italian word, novella, which means new. The realistic content and form of these tales influenced the development of the English novel in the 18th century, as well as the short story in the 19th century. The most important differences between novels and novella are page length, number of words, fast pacing, etc. So with this video comes to an end. In the next session, I will be dealing with introduction to R.K. Narayan, who is the author of Talkative Man, the novella, which is there for you as a text. So meet you in the next video. Thank you. Thank you very much.